The eyes of the tech world are on Silicon Valley this morning, where Apple has held an online version of its annual Worldwide Developers Conference.
Yes, it is the big event for anyone who's anyone in the world of tech, when we get to see some of the big changes and inventions coming to a device near you. And today, tech expert Trevor Long has been up very early to tune in. I mean, Trev, you'd normally be there.
Filthy.
Not this year.
No frequent flyer points this year. This is Cupertino behind me, the Steve Jobs Center. That's where they kind of host the event every year. And this event was essentially a live stream of a pre-produced keynote, very, very slick production. And instead of having 2,500 people in a room, mostly developers, the people that build the apps that we all use, they were all online at different times of the day around the world watching it themselves. And no one at all is in Silicon Valley for this event.
OK, let's talk about the changes, the big changes, the iPhone.
Yeah, so later in the year, every iPhone from the iPhone 6S upwards, so that's a lot of years' worth of iPhones, will get a new version of the software, iOS 14. And there's a lot of changes, but a couple, I think, the fundamental ones is you'll see what they call an app library. And instead of having pages and pages and pages of apps, you'll actually be able to delete the pages and just have one quick swipe reference to suggested apps, relevant apps that you use regularly, and it's going to be kind of smart, so it'll actually think for you about which apps you might be wanting. And then on the actual home page, instead of having four apps across and five apps down, you can actually have what we call widgets. Now, these are kind of glimpses inside an app. So if you, for example, you've got a news app, instead of having to click the news app to see what's in it, you'll actually see headlines right there on your home screen. All of these things, by the way, have been on Android phones for many years, but it's taken Apple a while to find a way that they want to present it in their own unique style. So that'll be coming to all iPhones later in the year.
So they're playing catch up. Hey, Apple's also announced that they're working on a way to use your smartphone as your car key.
In America, next month, you'll be able to buy a BMW 5 Series that you can open with your iPhone. So you tap your iPhone on the door handle, it opens, you put your phone in the charging port and you can start the car. So basically, your phone becomes your car key. And you can even send a message to your friends with a key to your car. So Carl, if you wanted to borrow my car, I could send you a text and you would get a key that you could use on your phone. So that's very early days technology that I think in 5 or 6 years will become the norm for the way we access our cars.
Does that also mean if you lose your phone, you lose your car key?
I would have thought there are security aspects of that are well worth raising, aren't they?
Exactly. In the same way that if you lose your phone, you lose your credit card now, you just wipe your phone. And it's also fingerprint and face ID authorised.
Okay. Mm. Now, what about the Apple Watch?
Yeah, a couple of fun little software updates to the Apple Watch. One of them is sleep tracking. So at the moment, you take your Apple Watch, it's pretty much useless at nighttime, but you'll be able to now track your sleep. And what Apple's trying to work on is a way to kind of get you towards a better bedtime and wake you up more gently. But also, I kind of think this is a little bit in the era and the daytime, but they've got a hand washing recognition. So it'll know that you're washing your hands. It'll start a 20-second timer so that you know that you're washing your hands correctly for 20 seconds, and it'll keep a log of how often you're washing your hands. Pretty important in this day and age, I guess.
I guess.
It's just, is there any personal responsibility left in the world?
We're just running our lives.
I don't know.
No, you need to be reminded of these things.
Yeah, right.
Now, Trevor, I mean, we normally get a really big announcement at this event. There's always so much hype, so much excitement and rumours of new technology. What have we heard this year?
The event ended with a slide that said, historic day. But there was no hardware. There was no exciting new products. It's all very much behind-the-scenes stuff that is very nerdy. They're moving away from Intel processors, but no new products, no exciting announcements other than all the software we've just talked about.
So all a little bit dull then?
Not totally dull, but I do like a new hardware, like a new Mac or a new iPhone or something to get excited about. This software is months away from being used, so it'll be in everyone's iPhones, but, you know, you like a bit of new Apple hardware now and then.
You're just not happy this morning, Trev, are you?
When are
we
going to see
that?
You're
not there. There's no big announcement.
I'm not in Cupertino.
You got up early for nothing.
No, not for nothing, but this is going to change a lot of people's iPhones and the way they use their software, but I'm not getting a new Mac anytime soon.
Jeez, you look so tired.
What time did he wake up?
Thank you, Trev.